about the parameters of GPP, NEP, and RE, kind of in general. We also talked about them related to terrestrial or earth systems above water. Now we will delve into aquatic systems and talk about how these parameters are similar and how they differ when you're talking about systems that are underwater. We should discuss the fact that photosynthesis does take place underwater. And I think most of you kind of know that intuitively, but maybe you don't think about it very often. So who does this photosynthesis? That includes phytoplankton, so seaweed and photosynthetic bacteria, and also aquatic plants. And these organisms, these photosynthetic organisms, grow near the surface of water or in shallow water systems. These are critically important organisms because they power the aquatic food chain. The photosynthetic reaction in aquatic systems is exactly the same as the reaction that takes place in terrestrial or above ground systems. And so just to review it, you have carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide dissolves into the water column and that reacts with water. And then sunlight that filters in through the water column catalyzes the reaction, and the plants convert this carbon dioxide and water into a sugar. So here's our sugar molecule and oxygen. And the difference in this reaction underwater is that the oxygen is dissolved in the water and it's not existing as a gas. So just note for the next slide that oxygen is created by photosynthesis. We didn't talk about this as much with our terrestrial systems. But oxygen is limiting in underwater systems, and so it's very important to note that this is created in the photosynthetic reaction. And then, of course, that means that the opposite happens with respiration. So just like photosynthesis takes place in aquatic systems, so does respiration. And respiration, if you recall, it's just the reverse reaction of photosynthesis. So in this case, you have sugar being used up in the plant. It's being burned to create energy, and oxygen is consumed in respiration. So oxygen and sugar are consumed. This releases energy, and it releases carbon dioxide gas and water molecules. And so we can use this to measure, if we measure RE, we can also look at NEP and GPP. In these systems, we do have some constraints. So phytoplankton are very short-lived, and so it's very hard to measure biomass changes because they're constantly dying off and then new phytoplankton are emerging. So the biomass change is not as apparent. However, we can measure the change in dissolved oxygen in these systems because I did mention it's limiting. So you can see how much oxygen gets consumed or generated in a system, and that tells you how much respiration or photosynthesis is taking place. So scientists, people like me and you, came up with very simple but very ingenious experiments in order to determine how much NEP and RE is taking place in these aquatic systems. And these are really simple. The idea is that they take two bottles. One bottle allows light into the bottle, so it's a transparent glass bottle. And they put phytoplankton and water into the bottle and measure the dissolved oxygen levels in that water when they initially put the phytoplankton in there. Then they seal up the bottle and measure dissolved oxygen again after 24 hours. So 24 hours is important because phytoplankton don't have a long life cycle, and so you don't want to wait too long before you check them again. In the other bottle, you can see in the picture, it's very dark. These bottles are wrapped in a black or dark tape that keeps light from getting into the bottle. And so in this bottle, you only have respiration taking place. There is no photosynthesis because light can't get into the bottle. So you do the same thing. You fill this with phytoplankton and water, wait 24 hours, and check the dissolved oxygen at the beginning and after 24 hours have passed. So let's go back to our light bottles and talk about what we can determine from these. So we know that light can get into these bottles. So the phytoplankton in these bottles have two competing reactions taking place. They have photosynthesis and respiration. And so this then is the same as net ecosystem production, or NEP. NEP equals GPP, so this is fueled by photosynthesis, minus the amount of respiration that takes place. Okay, so NEP is what we're learning from this light bottle. So the NEP is measured quantitatively by looking at how much dissolved oxygen is in the light bottle after 24 hours of incubation compared to or minus the initial amount of dissolved oxygen that was in the bottle when you first sealed it up. Okay, so what can you tell from these measurements? So if the amount of oxygen increases in the bottle, that means that, so if this number increases and NEP is positive, that means that more photosynthesis was taking place than respiration. If NEP is negative, so if this number is less than the initial DO, then that means that there's more respiration taking place than photosynthesis, and that will make this number a negative value. In the dark bottle, things are a little simpler. Only respiration can take place, and so when you measure the initial DO, so imagine there was 8 milligrams per liter of oxygen dissolved in the water at the beginning of your experiment, and then you take the measurement again later and it has 6 milligrams per liter of dissolved oxygen, then that means you've lost 2 milligrams per liter of dissolved oxygen. That's the amount of respiration that took place. So this is a simpler measurement. Respiration is just the difference between initial DO and the DO after 24 hours in the dark bottle. Now that we know that the change in the dissolved oxygen, or DO, in the light bottle represents NEP, and the change in dissolved oxygen in the dark bottle represents RE, or respiration, we can use this information to calculate GPP of the system. And so I'll just remind you, GPP equals NEP plus RE. And we know then if we put those all together, we have the light bottle DO minus the initial DO, which is NEP, plus initial DO minus dark bottle DO, which is RE. If you add all of that together, the two initial DO readings will cancel out, and you're left with the equation GPP equals the dissolved oxygen in the light bottle after 24 hours minus the dissolved oxygen in the dark bottle after 24 hours. So if you know these two readings, you can calculate GPP. So make sure you keep this equation handy. This is a really good equation that you can use to calculate GPP just by looking at, even if you don't know the initial DO, you can calculate GPP from these two readings. Another thing I want you to notice is that the change or difference in DO in the light bottle is NEP. So if I tell you the change in the light bottle minus initial DO, I'm telling you NEP. And if I tell you the change in the dark bottle, I'm telling you RE. So also remember that if you're told the difference between the initial and the dark bottle, or initial and the light bottle, you automatically know NEP or RE, respiration, without doing any calculations. Okay, so just keep track of all of these different equations and remember what each represents and what you can get from these different measurements as you proceed with the different calculations that are possible. The best way to demonstrate these different calculations is by looking at some examples. So first we'll start by looking at an example where you're given the initial DO in your light bottle and your dark bottle, and these both started at 8 milligrams per liter of oxygen, which is a pretty large amount. That means there's a lot of oxygen in these systems. And then the phytoplankton is put into the bottles that have all this oxygenated water, and they wait 24 hours after sealing them up and check again. And in the light bottle, the DO, the dissolved oxygen, is coming in at 8.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen. So over that 24-hour period, there's a lot of photosynthesis that took place, and there was a net increase in the amount of oxygen in the bottle. So looking at what this means, we know that NEP, the net ecosystem production, equals the light bottle DO after 24 hours minus the initial DO, so 8.5 minus 8 milligrams per liter of oxygen. So NEP in this bottle, which represents, you know, photosynthesis and respiration, is 0.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen. In the dark bottle, so on the right-hand side of our slide, we see again in the system, it started with 8 milligrams per liter of oxygen. And then after incubating for 24 hours, there's a lot of respiration taking place, but no photosynthesis. And so the amount of oxygen decreased down to 6.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen. So if we plug that into the equation for respiration, RE equals the initial DO minus the DO in the dark bottle after 24 hours. So that's 8. Minus 6.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen. So the RE measured in this bottle is 1.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen. So that tells us how much respiration took place in that bottle. If we combine these two values into the GPP equation, so now we know NEP, we know RE, and we know that NEP plus RE equals GPP, then we know that GPP in this system equals 0.5 plus 1.5 milligrams per liter, or a total of 2 milligrams per liter of oxygen. So that's how much photosynthesis took place in the light bottle. In this next example, I wanted to show you what it looks like if someone tells you what NEP is or RE is. So in this case, you're being told that the difference between the light bottle DO and the initial DO is 1 milligram per liter of oxygen. So after 24 hours, there was a net increase of 1 milligram per liter of oxygen in the light bottle. Additionally, you may be told that in the dark bottle, there was a decrease. So the difference between the initial DO and the dark bottle DO after 24 hours was 2.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen. So you aren't told what the initial DO is in either of these examples. You're just told what the difference is over time, which essentially is telling you NEP and RE. So that's a really simple calculation. If you're asked on the quiz, for example, what is RE in the system, you basically only need to know by how much did DO decrease in the dark bottle over 24 hours. So RE is 2.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen. If you're being asked for GPP, then you actually need to do a very simple calculation. You need to add NEP from the light bottle, that difference, plus the RE from the dark bottle measurements. So you just plug that in, 1 plus 2.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen, or in other words, GPP is 3.5 milligrams per liter of oxygen.